Hi, this is Jonathan. How you guys doing? Today's video is about IEMs, in-ear monitors. So this is a review of the FATfreq 20-6 IEMs. I want to thank FATfreq for sending this signature 20-6 for review. IEMs and headphones are really vital for musicians like me. I have two pairs of this, the 7506 from Sony, and I've been using this only for the studio at home or when I'm doing studio work, when I need a comfortable pair of headphones. And I will always bring this because I've used this for the longest time. 20-odd years ago in the studio, you know, I got hooked on this because I would spend long hours recording guitars with this pair of 7506. Not this actual pair, but, you know, with a pair of 7506. And it served its purpose. When I first started playing live, our concert, back in the 90s, you know, we were using stage monitors. So there's no need for IEMs. I didn't even know what IEM stands for. It's only later, around the year 2000, where the necessity of a pair of in-ear monitors, IEM, becomes very apparent. And I've been through all the, the various basic models, like the Westones, from the Westones to the Shure 846 that I'm using for the longest time. And I've been using the 846 for like a couple of years now. And it suits its purpose because the 846 have kind of like options for you to kind of boost up the low ends if you need to, or cut the low ends if you need to. And it's pretty expensive, right? But it's a great pair of headphones to use when you're touring, when you're playing with a band with IEMs and with whatever you're using, you know. And this pair of 20-6 from FATfreq comes up to a really surprising end result after testing it in the studio. Again, this is just a test that is done in here. I think the final test will be conducted when I'm doing a live show, whether it's a streaming show or a live show, with this. And then I can probably say that it would live up to my expectations. This pair of IEM has the clarity that I need. Sometimes IEMs, especially the the lower end ones, they tend to distort at the lower ends, at the lower frequency, and you kind of get this muffled thing. And, you know, as musicians, especially guitarists like me, we tend to crank up a whole lot. And as the show goes on, you know, you're gonna get ear fatigue, and you're gonna start cranking up on your wireless IEM set, and it'll tend to get distorted. So I always make it a habit not to do that because I don't want to blow my ears. So I keep it at a very minimal level. But as the show goes up, I'll probably tweak it up a little bit more. And the 846 so far has served its purpose. You know, it's relative low output that would guarantee very low distortion. Now, this pair has high outputs. This is a 6-driver IEM, and I find it to be really clear on the low ends as well as the mids. Now, the highs are not overblaringly loud as like some IEMs tend to be. Sometimes you have IEMs that go this way. This is kind of flat in a way, but with a little bit of emphasis on the low frequencies. Now, the highs are just nice. They're not like brash. They are, you know, you can hear hi-hats But you know, especially with hi-hats, when Jimmy plays hi-hats, it gets really loud. So this will kind of like tame down the brashness of the high frequencies, and it's just nice, you know. And I can hear, I can probably hear like Jimmy's drum set in a very comfortable level. But then again, like I said, you know, the real test will be when I do a live show with this pair of IEMs. The good thing about this FATfreq is that this is a local company, so they're all Singaporeans, so I'm very proud of them. You know, and it's founded by three young men, Aaron, Ivan, and Ben. And all three are engineers, so they decided to form this company. And right now they have a team of six nice-looking chaps, as you can see here. They have a really nice, humble office-cum-workshop. And I went there. They actually reached out to me, so I went there with Thomas, and we paid them a visit and took a look around them. And they showed me how they do stuff, you know. And they didn't show me too much though. But the good thing about FATfreq is that you have the option to customize your plate, right? So this is a steampunk theme plate that I requested for. You have other designs, of course. I will show it here. And you have the options to kind of like customize your in-ear monitors if you choose to. But apart from these vanities, it's the sound that that is most important. And I find that this 20-6 is pretty good. Under the Signature series, you have a couple more models ranging from different frequency ranges. You have a 3 drivers, you have a 8 driver ones, which is the top of the line, and then you have the 6 driver, which is this. Now, apart from that, they also have the musician's range, which ranges from the price of $199 to $499. And they are more catered to it's a more flat response in a way. Maybe a bit emphasis on the low, just a touch of the lows, for musicians, basically, you know. And you have another series that is catered for, they call it the reference series, which is catered for the monitor soundman or the front of house, FOH soundman, you know, or engineer in the studio. Now, these people will probably want a more flat response in what they are hearing. So this series is catered for them. Now, the Signature series is meant for guys who are a little bit more demanding in what they want to hear, and henceforth the price range. So I'm pretty stoked that they actually sent me a pair of this, and I'm loving this. So I've tested this to my studio setup, and I compared it to the 846, the SE 846, and I find this to be a little bit more clearer. I can actually hear more and feel more. So the bass frequency is a little bit more enhanced, but not overly enhanced. I can hear. Now, mind you, the 846 supposedly had a subwoofer in there somewhere, but I can actually hear the bass frequency, but not as much as the 846. The 846 has this low, deep thing going, which I can feel. Do not have that much. It does have the low frequency, like I said, it has a low frequency boost, and I think it's just nice. And part of the ear fatigue that I get when I'm playing long hours in a show is probably from all frequencies, not just the high frequencies. Every frequency plays a part, because you tend to get caught up in the moment, you know, within the show. And like I said, you know, in my mix from my IEM, I'm hearing like 100%, 70% is like guitars, you know, just my guitar, and then the other guitarist, and then bass. This is my order, and then the rest of the band, especially the drums, so I can keep time. Vocals are not really the loud unless I'm singing, because I don't want to be out of tune. So these are my preference when I'm setting up my IEMs, or you know, setting up my Avions and stuff like that. And it's really vital that I have a pair of IEM that doesn't distort or go out of whack. And that's the reason why I'm very particular about IEMs, especially when I'm doing a show, right? So I thought I'd let you guys know about this option that you have, especially if you're in Singapore. You might just want to check out FATfreq, FATfreq. Really, really smart, like flat frequency, right? And it's run by, like I said, Aaron, Ivan, and Ben, and a couple more guys. And they're all nice people. You just might give them a call and pop down to the shop and take a look. This pair is not cheap. This is about 1,022 Singapore dollars. right? And of course, there are other ranges here. I just want to check them out and just find out. And I believe even the lower ends, where it goes from 199 with the two drivers, are pretty good sounding too. It's about how they tweak the frequency. So it's also a matter of personal preference, you know, what you like to hear. So it's best to go down there and kind of test out which one do you like, right? So let me know what you think about this pair of IEMs from FATfreq, and leave a comment in the comment section down below, right? And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up and join this channel and subscribe to this channel and press that bell to be notified of future videos and be part of Patreons to support this channel. I need the support. I want to thank my present Patreons and future Patreons for their love, friendship. In the meantime, you guys, please take care of yourself. Now remember to protect your ears, especially when you're playing live. You know, a good pair of IEMs will save your ears, right? Take care now. Ciao.